In 2009, the first version of Chrome was launched, and at the time it was a cutting-edge browser that really disrupted the web browser's market shares. But would it still be able to handle today's websites? Let's find out in this video. The first test is Reddit. Reddit used flex layout on almost everything on the page, which is not supported until Chrome version 29. So the result is most of the elements were aligned incorrectly. Here you can also see the up and down vote buttons and several icons were missing. This because they use iconic font and loaded with add font face, which is not supported until Chrome version 4. The plus sign at the join button is also missing because they use an inline SVG image, which is also not supported until Chrome version 4. Next test is YouTube. It looks like the site was reverted back to the classic mode. The video player is broken. The old version of YouTube used Flash Player and they switched to HTML5 at around 2015, apparently not supported by the first version of Chrome. Also, all of dynamically loaded content were missing due to incorrect source location, probably problems with the JavaScript. The YouTube logo at the top was not scaled properly due to the background image size property was not supported until the version 4. Let's try CodePen, one of the most popular web developers code sharing. I was greeted by an old version of reCAPTCHA that I have to tick the checkbox and copy the verification code manually in order to pass the test. And after reCAPTCHA, it seems there are some problems with their dynamically loaded content and nothing is showing at all. Facebook. Surprisingly works. Even the content was dynamically loaded well. Almost everything works except the links that you can click on. If you look at the profile image, you see the square image instead of circle due to the border radius is not working until 6 months later with the Chrome version 4. Instagram. The site was completely broken and nothing to be seen at all. Looking at the console, the whole content was supposed to be dynamically loaded with JavaScript, and it appears that the grandpa Chrome was unable to handle this code at all. Bummer. And the next test is Twitter. They switched to Twitter mobiles with low profile web design. Personally, I think this is kind of brilliant and cost effective, as most users use Twitter apps anyway, so they only just maintain the mobile site with a low profile design as a fallback for older browser support. Wikipedia. This is quite a surprise. Completely messed up despite the site is quite simple and takes space. After I look at the code, I found that most of the margin properties were coded in media query, which only became fully supported by Chrome version 21 and above. And that's the reason why the whole site was messed up and overlaying each others. So after these tests, I feel that web development technology has evolved and changed dramatically in the past 10 years, to the point that the cutting-edge browser at that time is completely unable to handle today's website anymore. So it is really important for us developers to keep learning new things. And that's all for this video. Don't forget to subscribe to stay tuned for more development tips and tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye!